הרוממך אדוני כי דיליתני ולא שימחת אויבי לי. אדוני אלוהי שיבעתי אליך ותרפאני. אדוני העלית מן שאול נפשי, חייתני מיורדי וור. כי חילצת נפשי ממוות, את עיני מן דמעה, את רגלי מדחי, את הלך לפני אדוני בארצות החיים. These sentences from the Psalms of King David are as a symbol for survivors over 70 years. We say them all daily in the morning or in the days of Hallel, in the festivals. And a special meaning to thank the Lord Almighty for our survival, which is a miracle indeed. As it was mentioned, I am here since 1988, 31 years of March of the Living. I didn't miss even one of them. But this year is dedicated for two things. First of all, to speak a little bit about the Greece Jewry, Saloniki, and other cities in Greece. And the second point is the fight against anti-Semitism, which is especially needed, this fight, last year. About Saloniki, not only Saloniki, Giacintos that was mentioned here. I want to add you to your information. The Gestapo came to Giacintos in Greece on the 9th of September, 43. The head of the Gestapo came to the mayor of Giacintos, Lucas Carreri, telling him, give me the list of the Jews living in your city, in Giacintos. I give you 2 days, give me the names and the addresses. He said to him, I don't have a list of Jews. I have citizens of Giacintos. I didn't ask them what is the identity, what is the religion, what is the faith. They are citizens of Giacintos. I cannot give you. 2 days, 6 o'clock in the morning in the headquarters of the Gestapo here, you bring me the list. He went to the Archimedes. He went to Christomos. Carreri went to the bishop, asking him what to do. And Christomos said him, you will not give even one name. They are your citizens. They are people as we. No, they want to send them to Europe. They don't want to send them, said the bishop. They want to kill them, to murder them. Don't give the name. 2 days later, the Gestapo sent someone to the mayor. Where is the list? He said, I told you. Say the head of the Gestapo, I don't have any list. I don't know. He was brought with the bishop to the Gestapo quarter, and they, the two people, gave the Gestapo an envelope with a heavy letter, heavy envelope. They opened the envelope. There was the list of people to be sent away from Giacintos. In the list were not 275 Jews of Giacintos, 275. In the list were two names, Lucas Carreri, mayor of Giacintos, Bishop Christomos, the Archimandrite. If you want to send away, we are the two. None of the Jews in Giacintos was sent to Europe, to Auschwitz. All of them survived, all of them. They were sent by these two people in a ship, by night, to another place, and they saved and they survived. In Mount in the Mount of Remembrance mentioned by you, Archbishop Bartolomeo, there is a head department of righteous among the nations. From Greece are two names tattooed in the Mount of Remembrance in Jerusalem, Christomus and Lucas Careri. We will never forget them. For us, they were the stars, as all the other righteous among the nations, the stars in the black, dark tunnel of 6 years that we were in that tunnel. They were the stars who give the light, who give the hope, and to make us human beings. When the Pope Franciscus came to Jerusalem and visited Yad Vashem, he pointed out one word. Instead of speaking about the Lord, about the Master of the Universe, let's speak about ourselves. The first question the Lord Almighty asked the first human being, Adam, is one word in Hebrew, Ayeka, which means, where are you? Human being, where are you? Where were they? Two leaders of Zakynthos, they are exceptions, extraordinary. They are not the usual way. They were abnormal. And the other righteous and the magnanations as well. We have to ask ourselves today, Ayeka, where are you, mensch, human being? Do you behave as it has to be? Anti-Semitism. In my eyes, anti-Semitism is a madness, an epidemic madness. It's crazy. It doesn't pay any logic, any logic. I don't speak about the contribution of the Jewish people all over the history for mankind, in all fields of contribution. I speak about logic, the minimum of logic. When we were in Poland, here, in Oświęcim, Krakow, or all the other cities in Poland, 3.5 million Jews, 8 years ago, 3.5 million Jews. People said, yes, there are some anti-Semites because the Jews don't behave like the others. They don't look like the others. Look at their suits. Look at the beards. Look at the hats, Streimel. They don't speak even Polish, some of them. Yiddish, a little bit Hebrew. If they would be like us, no hatred. No, just the contrary. We will embrace them. We will kiss them. They are so brave. They are so clever. They are so intelligent. Be like us. 1 meter from Poland is Germany. In Germany, the Jews didn't wear like me. The suits were normal suits, no Streimel. They didn't speak Yiddish. They spoke German, not worse than the German people, maybe even better. They produced the Rothschilds, Albert Einsteins, and many others. No, did they love us in Germany? Did they embrace us? Did they kiss us? We are equal. We are not different. We are not strange. Be friendly. In Poland, because we were different. In Germany, because we were not different. Then in every metro station, you could find a graffiti. Jews to Palestine, in all the languages in Europe. Which means we hate you because you are here in our home. If you will have a home of yourself, if you will be independent like all the other nations, we will embrace you. We will be friendly. We will appreciate your contribution to mankind. So, 1948, finally, we have received an independent state and we became owners of our old homeland, the land of Israel. No, ask our neighbors. Did they accept us? Did they say hello? Welcome to the Middle East? Back home? After 2,000 or 3,000 years? So it doesn't pay any logic. You hated us here because we are strange. You fight us there because we are at home. So decide, what do you want from us? We are human beings. What do you want? What do you expect? Give us to understand. Logic we are. Understand we can. Just say the correct words. We have to give an explanation to the world that anti-Semitism is a madness. It doesn't make any logic. It's real madness. A young boy from San Diego, from California, 19 years old, Ernst, what did we do him any harm? Why? To take a rifle and to enter into a synagogue and to shoot and to kill innocent people, why? What did we do to them? And the murderer of Pittsburgh and the murderers here and there in Argentina and Moscow, wherever. Anti-Semitism, you need a psychologist. To fight anti-Semitism is not a logic fight. You need a medicine. Maybe I don't have it, but we have to explain our attitude, our position, and this is the only way to show the entire world that we exist, that we are eternal, that we have our continuity from generation to generation, in spite of Auschwitz-Birkenau. An immortal nation, and so will be forever. Am Israel Chai.